be prepared for highly offensive language from the start and throughout, and adult and sexual themes.
Casual Monday. It is Bank Holiday Monday, and we are kicking off the first full week of the new series. Oh dear. 7 nights a week. Help us all. Listen, it might be the end of a long weekend, but the party has definitely not stopped here on Box. But listen, before we go any further, I just want to clear one thing up, right? Farrah says she's the queen of reality TV. Janice thinks that she is the queen of reality TV. Well, listen, neither of them are, because I am. All right, I'm going to own that now. And it was written in my contract, so legally, I am. Glad we cleared that up. Listen, it's been another dramatic day in the Celebrity Big Brother house. Austin argued with Farrah, James argued with Farrah, and Janice is just arguing with everyone. I think she was arguing with the swimming pool at one point. We're going to be bringing you all the latest news and house exclusives, so you lot are the first with all the gossip. And also tonight we're going to be discussing how Team UK have been shaping up against the USA crew. The Speakmans are going to be here. They're back. They're going to be divulging what the housemates' artistic endeavours reveal about them. And for the first time this series, our favourite LA correspondent's going to be here, Michelle Visage, who is speaking to. We love her. She's going to be giving us her take on the series so far. We've got a lot to talk about, and I need a little bit of assistance to do it, but luckily enough, I've got a good old panel, so it's time to find out who's on the guest list in the Bots Diner tonight. While the Tash is away, the Richie will play. He's used to being 1 in 5, but on my panel tonight, he's 1 in 3, which he's pretty much more used to these days. It's actually Richie Neville! Hey! Good evening. Good evening. And bringing glamour to my panel and music to my ears, it's my own big reunion with the gorgeous Michelle Hyam! And finally, I want a ton of woos for the man with the headlines.
Woo!
It's like a bad joke.
That went well.
Wow. It's done well! Yeah! Clearly love you. Big fan, so. All right, let's try and unpick a bit of tonight's action step by step. Let's start with Austin and Farrah's argument about her so-called fake ass. The fake ass. Rich, what's your take on the ass?
At the end of the day, it's her ass, right? Yeah. So if she wants to answer a question about it or not, that's up to her, you know? I mean, I guess it's a free country, they can discuss it if they want, but, you know, it's up to her if she wants to answer or not.
Talk about the arse. Yeah. Michelle, do you think he was being provocative, like Janice said?
No, I think that he was just trying to find a lead on from the conversation to fill dead air, and she just took it too personally. She's taken everything too personally.
Yeah, she's
and that's
too,
all it was.
She's so insecure, Farrah, yeah. I feel.
Massively
insecure.
Well, one thing James thought, James actually thought Farrah was being provocative when she called him slip and slide. So, Dan, what are you making of that statement? What were you getting from it?
Well, we have all discussed the
term
slip and slide.
Oh, here we go!
Slip and slide, even me!
Different definitions.
We have different theories, but look, here is the reality with what she said.
Go
she was making a sexual innuendo about James' sexuality. And the thing is, to me, firstly, that's ridiculous. I know James, he's as straight as they come, sadly.
Have you tried? I've been banging on that door!
Oh yeah, oh yeah. But the wider point is, though, how dare she try and make him feel uncomfortable about sleeping in the bed with a gay man who is a mate? And that is absolutely what she was trying to do. I really, really hope that it doesn't affect his friendship with Austin, because that would be her winning. And I think there was a tiny little bit of sort of, you know, a homophobic undertone there.
Well, listen, this, it has split a lot of people. Most people are agreeing with you, but some people think that James might have overreacted, Rich. What are you making of that statement?
I think it's the ambiguity of, if that's a word.
Big word, Rich. Right? Big word.
I think it's the confusion, should I say,
well done.
About this slip and slide thing. Because as soon as I had it, I was like, what does she even mean by that? And I think he was feeling the same, and it just made him feel uncomfortable. He's like, well, what exactly are you saying?
It seems that everyone's got a bit of a different view what she meant.
I think I know what she meant.
Come on, then. Tell us all.
I think that she meant... OK, how do we say this cleanly?
There's no way.
She meant that James wouldn't have time to notice because his slip inside would be too quick because it's a slip and slide.
Do you know what I think, Mish? You've got a dirty mind.
Does that make sense? I thought that was a really clean way of saying it. Ryland's looking at me really wrong. Oh my God, am I wrong?
How quick are we talking here? Do you think she was out of line for what she was basically trying to insinuate?
I think Farah is out of line with everything that she says, so yes.
That's what Michelle thinks. Well, it's a James and Austin. They seem really comfortable with their bromance. Do you think the house just needs to stay out of that relationship? Like, they're mates, Rich.
Yeah, it's got nothing to do with them anyway, so it was a little bit weird that they're sort of picking on them about it. But I feel like there's this, you know, the sort of difference in cultures. Yeah. Because I think that Americans have got a different way about it than Brits. I think we're way more comfortable with it.
But James is just a flirt. I mean, let's not forget the fact
James will flirt with a front door.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And you can definitely tell he is getting a boost from Austin. He is.
It's a little bit narcissistic. We were chatting about this earlier, and it's just like, look, James is clearly straight, Austin is gay, but what people will seem to be forgetting, Austin has been married for 5 years. He's in a committed relationship. James just enjoys the attention.
He loves attention, doesn't matter where he's getting it from. But we were saying, actually, and I think that Farah is probably just jealous, you know, actually, James never showed any sexual interest in her, and I think that really surprised her.
Can I interject there as well? You know the argument between Farah and James the other night when she said, you're looking at me? I felt that what she was really saying was,
I want you to
why aren't you looking at me more?
So thank you.
Not disappointing. I mean, we need to get rid of the speakmans. We're poor Richie Neville on stage. They're going to have a go at me. Lizzo, we saw Farah and Austin make up at the end of the episode tonight. Dan, do you think that's a bit of an uneasy truce? Do you think it's more like, let's just try and play nice?
Oh, yeah, that's not going to last at all. I mean, the thing is, as well, I should say here, I'm not a fan of Austin either. And I get the sense that Austin has a little bit of the Perez Hilton in him. I saw that on launch. I really see that. So I think there's a lot more to come from Austin. I think he has a massive ego. I think he's in there to cause fights and know the truce will not last.
Well, let's see what you think. What are we making of the whole shenanigans? Oh, Martin's back. He was on the phone last night.
I love it. I love Farah.
Yeah, you love Farah.
What?
I love Farah so much. You love Farah. Tell us why.
Because she can create an argument and then just walk away and everyone else has to pick up the piece.
Isn't that what makes a great housemate?
And this is what we want to see. I don't want to see people being nice. I want them to create havoc.
Do you know what? To completely disagree, she will find anything to argue. And if you've seen her put makeup on 24/7, she wants everyone to bow down and say, you're amazing. No one is, so she's annoyed. And that's why
she's... That's a real Jeremy Kyle clap then.
Well done, well done.
Well, listen, we're going to be talking about this a little bit more later on, but let's move on to the so-called queen of reality herself, Janice. She stepped into the argument between James and Farah saying she was the ambassador of peace. Go. Richie, have you seen any evidence of the peace side of Janice yet?
Absolutely not. I mean, let's face it, she's batshit off the Richter scale, isn't she? She's just, you know, I mean, I have seen a sensitive side. There are times when I've seen her face go very concerned, but then she always brings the conversation.
Okay, fine.
But behind all that,
Michelle,
I can see
it's
going to
be us in a few years' time. We better not start.
I'm on my way. I'm halfway down.
But with Janice, sorry, Dan. Dan's a massive Janice fan. Mm-hmm. But I feel that Janice is a veteran at reality TV.
She is
most definitely playing a game in every way for airtime with the housemates. When she first went in, I watched her and she went around every single person and got common ground, common interest. Get them on side and then mess with their heads.
Well, one thing that we did see, she had a bit of beef with half the house tonight for using up all the hot water. Dan, do you think she had a fair point, or was she just a bit out of line?
Well, of course she didn't have a fair point on any level, but that is what makes Janice absolutely brilliant, because she believes what she says so much, and it doesn't matter what the rights or wrongs are. I mean, I actually think, right, and obviously you aside, she is the queen of reality TV. Reality TV.
Listen, they wrote it in the script as a joke. I don't agree with it myself. I think she is. I'm not joking.
She is absolutely incredible. She is what Celebrity Big Brother is made for. This is just the start. You know, knowing Janice like I do, there are a lot of twists and turns to come.
Oh, believe me, it's all been twisting about in there today. We'll be seeing that tomorrow night on the main show. But Jenna took the opportunity to tell Janice some home truth. She sort of went in. Michelle, whose side were you on out of Jenna and Janice?
In that particular scene, I would have to say Janice. I thought that it was unprovoked and Jenna kept attacking Janice, waiting for a reaction, and Janice wasn't giving her it. Mm. And then I felt when Farah stepped in, it was like two mean girls attacking, which she is, an older lady. Mm. And I think regardless of her being strong enough to deal with it, I thought in that situation was wrong. And I thought the two of them could be slapped, and they just acted like absolute idiots.
And we never condone violence on this show.
Obviously not.
I think things really quickly escalated, especially between Austin and Janice, about cleaning the bath, which resulted in Janice receiving a formal and final warning, we can let you know. But no one saw really what happened there. Dan, this is something that Big Brother obviously takes really, really seriously. What's your whole views on what happened?
Well, I was a bit gutted because I'm just a bit worried for Janice, because she does have a tendency to fly off the handle, and I would hate for her to do something that would get her removed from the house. Yeah. It would be such a shame. So I'm nervous for her. I'm worried for her.
It's likely, though, isn't it, Dan?
It's possible. It's possible, but you know what?
No, but
here's the thing. She's an intelligent woman. She really is. And I think that she felt a little bit scolded by that. I think she probably realised she slightly crossed the line. Mm-hmm. But I didn't think it was that serious.
I mean, the thing is, I think without, it's not worth going into it. Big Brother's decision's final, as you see. She's got her first and final warning for that, so she has got to be on her best behaviour.
Yes.
But like we saw with like Chloe and other people going, oh, she didn't actually spit, or did she, you know, it's...
From her reaction, I'd say she was devastated with herself.
Yeah.
And you could see that. Mm. So well, listen, I'd say that she'll keep herself to herself for a little while.
We've got a lot more to talk about, but for now, give it up for our panel, guys. Still to come, I've got all the latest from the house. Plus, I'm going to be going all Art Attack with the Speakmans. They're going to be getting to the bottom of the housemate's psyche by looking at some of their artistic creations. I'll see you straight after this break. It is a brand new week on Bots, and just in case there is still any confusion, we established in part one that it's not Farah or Janice who's the queen of reality TV, it's actually me. Yeah. Very serious. It's time now for your first exclusive of the night. Have a little look at this one, and it's juicy. But seriously, I am the queen of
the I'm very sorry. I apologise about my behaviour. I was out of line.
Mm-hmm.
And
can we do this in a minute?
I haven't brushed my teeth yet.
Well, I'll stand here. Austin, I'm terribly sorry for my behavior.
Okay.
I was completely out of line for being a pantomime babe. Actually, a pantomime dame. And I'm truly sorry.
Okay.
Do you accept my apology?
We can have a chat about it later.
You don't accept it.
My brain's not really working yet.
Well, mine never works.
Ooh, the morning after the night before. Rich, what did you make of that?
I think he's been, like, you know, I guess if it's really, really annoyed him, if he feels he's been spat at, maybe he has a right.
Oh, he's been an idiot.
No, I think he is.
He
should
actually,
you know,
take it. Take the apology. That was
no, maybe
he
should have said something along the lines of, I can't forget it, but I forgive it.
Well, he's an idiot. He's stringing it along now, isn't he?
And Janice actually has a real heart. That came from the heart. She doesn't tell any lies. So she meant that, and he's a real yeah. idiot for not
he's
just
taking that. Yeah,
he was being on, just like, move on.
Offish. Yeah.
Yeah. No need.
Oh, I'm hearing a couple of grunts behind me. But we're getting into them a little bit later.
Are you grunting already?
But literally, I think I heard one person go. listen, as the housemates are settling into life in the world of Celebrity Big Brother, it is time to delve that little bit deeper in. I'm loving the music this series. It's so like showbiz. Let's not ever say that word again. Listen, who better to shed a little bit of light on their behaviour so far than my favourite psych duo for the first time this series and definitely not the last. Give it up for my gorgeous friends, the Speakmans! Oh, I love it. Well, listen, guys, UK and US housemates are getting used to life in Celebrity Big Brother, but I want to know how yous are enjoying it so far.
Brilliant.
Absolutely loving
Fantastic.
It.
Fantastic.
You know, there is such a big divide between the celebrities and the reality celebrities.
Oh.
Isn't there?
Yeah, that's
and,
true.
And then if you take the reality celebrities and divide them into USA and UK, that's what's going on because the reality celebrities are the ones that are just playing up to the camera.
And what are the main differences, like, bringing it back to the theme with UK and USA? What's the differences between the two teams? Can you clearly see that?
Well, I think the difference is that...
you smell lovely, by the way.
Thank you.
Oh!
How do you know that that's not me?
It's definitely not you. I've smelt you on the way in.
I think the thing is with the British, we are generally, we don't like confrontation and we are a little bit more reserved. Mm. Whereas sort of the Team USA, they don't seem to have those filters in place. So they kind of say it without the thought first. And therefore, they're a little bit more explosive. But like Nick said, you've got a big contingency from reality television and therefore they're there to perform.
Yeah, and they're used to it as well, aren't they? Like, we've had reality stars in previous series that are British and... they're really not levelling up, are they, to what the Americans are bringing us?
No, it's a big stage over there, and they do play up to the camera, there's no doubt about it.
Well, listen, I want to know a little bit more about them. So we've set up a little bots art gallery. Do you want to come over and we'll have a little chat? Come on, let's go to the gallery! I'm liking you. Here we go. Loving it. Right, OK, so let's start. So you asked our housemates before they went in... Oh, I'm liking the little gallery music as well. you asked our housemates before they went in to fill out a little picture, didn't you? So you
we
wanted to see
did.
Their part... you wanted them to draw their own past, present and future.
That's right.
Is that right? So let's start with Chloe. This is Stevie and Chloe. We're trying to get it to catch on. All right, I'm trying my hardest.
I don't think it is, though, is it, really? Let's be honest.
No, it's really not.
You're trying, though.
So whose is this one?
So this is Stevie here, and this is his past, present and future, and he's showing in the past that he was a shy guy.
Don't look at me, I'm shy.
Yeah?
Yeah.
He's now in the present, he's happy, and he's seeing his future here. Happy family, children.
Oh, yeah, the baby, kids.
Nice house, and a lovely TV career.
OK, so what does that say about him as a person?
Well, I think we already know that Stevie is a really nice guy.
Yeah, he's optimistic, he's always half full.
And do you know what? He had that little bromance going with Simon Cowell, and Simon Cowell does not take trolls gladly, does he?
No, he doesn't.
You know, so you know, Stevie is a lovely guy. Now, conversely, we've got a different story down here.
Oh, OK, so let's look at the other half. Let's look at Chloe.
Yeah, this makes me feel a bit sad, to be honest with you, because she loves her mum and dad and close links to mum and dad here.
Yeah.
But her present... that she sees with Stephen, she's also got the comedy and tragedy masks.
Yeah, what is that?
Well, with a big question mark underneath, because what she's saying is, as it's in the present, she doesn't know how it's going to go.
And the other interesting thing is that she's saying one day at a time. Stevie's saying, look, you know, I made
it. This is
it. And she's sort of saying just one day at a time, but her future is dot, 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 dot.
Not even written yet.
Oh, no.
I know, it's really sad, isn't it? But obviously, she is so insecure, and all the time in the house, as everyone's pointed out, she's touching him all the time. It's like, this is my man.
Look, Stevie and Chloe, look, they're a couple, they're engaged, they're saying they're in love. There is a lot of speculation about their romance, especially from a lot of the viewers and people online. Looking at these two pictures, does this look like something that could work?
They actually look poles apart, to be honest with you. And what concerns
me... I'm getting emotional.
We're not saying that it won't work. However, to work, I think that Chloe really needs to address her issues because currently, you know, it's quite a new relationship. Stevie, he keeps saying how beautiful she is.
He's propping the relationship up.
But he really sort of feels lucky that he's got this beautiful girl and feels like he's kind of punching above his weight. So he's currently being very submissive and currently he's allowing her to sort of dominate the relationship and he is allowing her to be insecure.
It was really sad seeing him so subservient tonight when she's with the bar. Yeah, it was really sad seeing
well,
that.
Listen, we're going to have to keep an eye on this one, definitely, yeah. I think. Let's move on.
Okay.
Let's move on to the Blue Gallery. Oh, here we go. Yeah. Farrah.
Yeah.
So what have we got here?
Do you know, this is so interesting, and I think that this is an incredible reflection of who Farrah is. So she shows her past here as stormy, cloudy,
rainy.
And her present, she's sort of got the beach and the sunshine, but what's really ironic is that how does she see her future? She sees her future with yachts and helicopters.
Oh, and a dolphin.
And a dolphin, yeah. But I think the dolphin's there to sort of say she's a cold fish, but she's very...
Not my words, the words of Ava Speakman. All right,
well, she's proving to be quite a cold fish, but it shows that her future is very, very material. And what sort of rings alarm bells to me about her motive in life is that I'm not seeing her child in there. Yet it was her child that kind of brought her the fame that she's got. And the thing is that she's a reality star and she got her fame through shocking people. And that is exactly what
and
she's
that's
doing.
That's all she knows what
that's
to do.
That's all she knows. And that's why she has no boundaries. And the other thing that is highlighted to me very much is the words that she uses. Children are very impressionable and she uses the same words. And just like a parrot that hears a word, they say it over and over, you're immature. Grow up.
She's obviously...
But the immaturity line, she's obviously heard many times. I'm not saying that she's not a troubled girl because she must be to be so defensive and so angry and the inability to listen to others. However, you know, I think that she's got a very clear motive, is that this is where I want to be.
And I'm going to get it.
And I'm going to get it.
OK, well, let's move on. Who have we got here? We've got Janice. Well, and what I love about this already is I'm not at all an artist. She's written at the top, so she knows that.
But you know what? Again, that depicts Janice's honesty.
Yeah. And what's this saying? Well, because I can't see anything.
Well, it's typical Janice, isn't it? It's all scribbles and chaos. Yeah. However, if you look at the big backdrop, there's a massive heart.
Yeah. And again, like Dan was saying, she's got a big heart.
You know, she has got a big heart. And scattered amongst that is all the people that are important to all the family, all the friends, you know, even the animals.
Is that she?
I think it's called Bella.
She's not a good artist, so it could be a sheep or a dog, couldn't it?
But or it could be a sheepdog.
You never know. You never know.
And that's why you're the queen.
So that this is Janice on a piece of paper, basically.
It's lovely.
I love it.
It's lovely,
I just love it. I mean, it just shows that she's a big heart. She's got lots of hearts inside. And like Nick said, I just think scribbles
and you
can
see that with that apology. I mean, it was a heartfelt apology. And, you know, it's...
Yeah, sad that you
look at that. I like that one. Yeah, Let's move on to our last one. Sherry.
Yeah.
I want to see more of her. I love her.
Yes, what do we?
I want to see more of Sherry. So this is very simple. I'm gathering this is past, present, future.
Yeah,
is that right?
That's what we asked for. So, again, Sherry's showing that the past was a bit of a storm. She's now living in the rainbow and she's aiming for sunshine. And I actually think that she does bring sunshine to us. I really like her. I think that she's a very lovely lady. This shows that there is no hidden agenda.
No, very simple.
Very simple.
Straight to the point.
Absolutely. I think she's just showing, look, this is what I want. This, you know, I've got no hidden agenda. All I want to do is just make the most of my time because all I want is the sunshine.
Yeah.
Like I said, like her very, very much. I don't think we've quite yet seen everything she's got to give.
Yeah.
However, I do think she's a really smart lady and I think she's kind of sitting back.
Oh, definitely.
And observing and a bit like Tash as well. I think they're kind of sitting back, observing,
letting it happen,
and then I think our girls will come to the forefront.
Joe, I really hope so. I want to see a bit more of her. But listen, it's been an absolute pleasure. I'm so glad you're back. Give up for Speakmans, everyone. Yeah. Listen, coming up, I've got all the latest news from the House, plus the housemates might be split between UK and USA, but there is no such divide here on Box because we are bridging the Atlantic as Michelle Visage is going to be giving us her views on all the action so far in What the Hell with Michelle. I'll see you straight after this break. To Celebrity Big Brother's bit on the side. Now we are chewing our booties out, trying to get to the bottom of all the conflict in the house. But it seems there's only one thing playing on Gal's mind.
Farrah said to James that you're a slip and slide, which is derogatory about, you know, it's like, you know, slipping into, you know, a gay guy with your butt up. That's what it means.
Hi. What would you like on your toast, quickly?
Just butter, please.
Okay. Favourite part of the night. And do you know what? For future reference, gal, I am Nutella all the way. But other spreads are available and all that, yeah. And that is then with the house divided here on Box. We are doing our bit for international relations because we're good like that. We are good like that. We have reached out to our favourite LA correspondent who has been keeping a close eye on what the hell her fellow countrymen have been up to. She's back. It's the one and only Michelle Visage.
Yes. Is this camera even on? How do you turn this thing on? Is it on? Hi, everybody. It's me. I'm back with What the Hell with Michelle. Team UK versus Team USA. Whoop, whoop. Okay, I'm going to break it down with my American teammates. Starting with the least known of the Baldwin brothers, it's Daniel Baldwin. He's been kind of flying under the radar, not doing much. But one thing is for sure, he has a big, fat wooden spoon, or so I've heard, and he is not ready to use it. He wants to stir that pot. He's going to be known as the agitator. So I think the best from Daniel's yet to come. Next up, Fat Man Scoop. Now, I only know Fat Man Scoop, besides that song, from New York radio. And one thing's for sure, he still loves the sound of his own voice. My God, I'd go insane. That guy talks a lot. He also fancies himself a neon Prince spandex tight-ass shirt. Austin! Now, Austin was laying in bed naked with another man that conveniently had lotion and then asked James to rub his hamstring that he pulled. Did we miss a rugby match in the garden or something? I wonder what his husband will think of that. Should be interesting. Maybe he'll want to join in. I'll watch. Janice Dickinson is up next. Now, one thing's for sure with Janice, you know what you're gonna get. She's balls to the wall with everything. I don't like, however, she's having minions, like Gail Porter's being her minion. I don't like that. Janice may be 60 years old, but the last thing she is inept. And there's actually nothing that woman won't do on camera. Jenna Jameson is up next. Now, I was in love with her before, but I'm even more in love with her now. Everybody was so quick to judge the porn star, but honey, she's not a porn star. She is the porn star. She built an empire. I loved how she handled the whole celebrity, celery, crazy kosher incident with Janice Dickinson. She walked up to her with class and dignity. She said, "This is my religion." Janice is the one who went apeshit on her. Not Jenna. So I can't wait to see what she's going to keep doing. I have to tell you, she could be an early pick for me as a winner. And hello, she's got a brand new beautiful ass. What could be better? Last but not least, we have Farrah Abraham. Now, I too, just like you, judged her from her antics here in the magazines and in the tabloids. But like Katie Hopkins, I'm gonna give her a clean slate and a chance to redeem herself. What she did with James, what she was on about, was absolutely bad. James did nothing wrong. You're in that tiny little house. You're gonna look at people. Hello, those lips, those boobs. How can you not want to look at her? She should take it as a compliment. She went crazy for no reason. So on that note, can't wait to see you next time on What the Hell with Michelle. Obviously, it's time for me to go to bed, so I'm off to go to sleep. And I'll see you next time, okay? Love you. Bye.
I love her so much. It gives me great pleasure to say that I should have her on the line now. Mish, are you there?
I love you, baby.
Yeah! Oh, babe, I missed you so much. Are you well?
I am so well. I can't wait to hug you soon enough.
I can't wait to see you. And stop press. Michelle's going to be here very soon. Mishy, I can't wait to see you. But listen, let's get stuck right into the house action. James has been causing a bit of a stir in the house. Are you a fan of him?
I actually love James. I love the way he handles himself. But I find it interesting that backdoor teen mom has grounds to judge anybody on their sexuality.
You cleaned the slate with Farrah, obviously. How's your slate looking at the moment?
Well, you know, listen, I gave everybody a chance. I did it with Katie Hopkins, which obviously did not work out. But Farrah, I'm trying. And this isn't working out either. But I will say this. with Jenna supporting Sarah, now I understand why people were telling me not to make friends with Katie Hopkins. I totally get it now.
She gets it. Mace, let's talk about Bobby. He's been given the role of Prime Minister. Do you think he's doing well, or do you think he's just crumbling around
him? I think he's lost the plot. Darling, you're not actually the Prime Minister. No, sweetie.
No, so you don't think he's doing a good job in there?
I think he's doing an okay job, but I think he's taking it a bit too... Like, he thinks he's the actual Prime Minister, which is quite cute.
I quite like it. And you said about Gail as well in your What the Hell. Do you think it's a wise move by Gail to pander to Janice?
I think it's an awful move. This is a strong, beautiful woman who's been reduced to Janice's minion. It's not a good look for her. She's not a servant. She's a beautiful beacon of light. Why is she doing this?
I know. Well, listen, talking of servants, I think it's going to start hotting up tomorrow with the task that's going to be going in. Michelle, I can't wait for you to get over here. When are you coming over?
I'm going to be there in less than 2 weeks.
Oh, yes! Mishi, there is a seat with your name on it and a cuddle coming from my arms. I miss you so much, and I'll see you soon. Love you lots. Give it up for Michelle, guys.
I love you.
Love you too. I love her. I love her. Listen, it is time to have now a little look at the house headlines in today's news. Oh, at 12:13 this afternoon, Stevie returned to the scene of the crime, but this time it was a party for two, and Chloe couldn't help but turn on her own set of waterworks.
Just if you're not ever happy, you
I think it would be very clear if I wasn't happy.
And you've got to tell me rather than lead me up the garden path, okay?
I would never lead you up the garden path.
Okay, babe,
I have gotten so many trains for you, and I've invested so much of my time.
Babe, I don't want you to.
Because I love you.
Babe, I don't want to get upset about it.
Yeah, because you were saying something that isn't right.
Oh, babe, come here. I didn't mean to upset you.
I've spent so much time.
Stop getting upset. What are you getting upset for?
Because
I didn't want you to. I'm not accusing you of nothing. I said if you are ever happy, you've got to tell me, babe. That's all I said.
On so many trains for him. And listen, if Stevie wasn't in the doghouse enough at 1:48 this afternoon, it became apparent he's also gotten under Jenna's skin and not in the way most men would want to.
You know what he said while I was sitting here? Yeah. He goes, you know, I actually wasn't really worried about Chloe. I was worried about how I would look. And I was like, you know what that felt like? He was like, since I got in the bathtub, or I put my feet in the bathtub, he was in a bathtub with Jenna Jameson, and that he would look bad.
I know.
I was like, what are you trying to say?
Bitching in the boudoir. Well, listen, with the house so full of controversy so early on, it fell to Sherry to provide some light relief.
You know what Americans do well that we don't is have health things, like health drinks. Because if you look at Scoops, that Scoops bag there, look, that green stuff. Why is that green powder then?
I don't know if that's protein or, like, something like spirulina, is it?
Spermalina?
Spirulina.
Oh, spirulina. I couldn't say, that's not a very good word. And that makes them, and it's, makes it's you like fart, a... does it?
I don't know if it makes you...
We've all been there. And if you happen to get any spermalina in your eye at 1:52 this afternoon, Chloe showed us exactly what not to do.
Yeah. Now I don't have a clip. Shit balls. I'm going to go get mine. Now I can rush by
you. I blinded myself. I've literally just been...
What happened? What did you put in there?
Some oil. I've got an oily eye.
You got an oily eye.
Yeah.
I'm sorry about that. Is that eye oil?
Oh. Yes.
Oh! Is it for your eye or not
your eye? No, I did this oil.
Oh, my God, I'm so
Let's
sorry
get some
about
oil.
That.
I'm going to jump by you again, Lobo.
I put oil in my eye.
Oh,
like
no,
it
you did
like
not,
really
did you?
It seemed like a idea at the time.
Oh, my God, I'm that's really going to be there forever.
That weren't oil, was it? That weren't oil. Now, listen, for an idea more pleasing on the eye... Do you get what I mean? The eye... At 2:50 this afternoon, James and Austin contemplated whether they'd go full throttle with something full frontal.
And would you ever do, like, a shoot where you have to be...
Naked? I'd never do a naked. No.
Show your full frontal?
No, I'd never do that. I just think that part of me is for my girl.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Yeah, I get my body out. My pose in a pair of pants, fair enough. You do that on the beach every day. But that bit of me is
You've been photographed with your ass, right?
Not really.
I'll fucking stick my cheeks right on the camera lens. I'm happy to show my bum. But luckily, not one picture of my willy has been leaked or released. But see, I don't do that. I don't take pictures and send them to people.
No.
But at the end of the day, I would do it if I was offered enough money.
What a shot. Let's make those. Coming up after the break, we've got tonight's final slice of house action for you. Plus, our panel and audience will be sinking their teeth into the UK and USA housemates. And we're going to be taking a look at the Battle of the Brides. See you after this. Battle of the Brides. Welcome back to Celebrity Big Brother's Bit on the Side. Now, listen, in the house, we've got the world's biggest porn star. Ooh. We've got the world's first supermodel. But all of that is nothing in comparison to this. Little bank holiday treat for you there. You're welcome. There you go. Listen, it is time to check in with the house for the final time tonight. And Clovey, I'm still trying to get it to touch it. It's not working. They're planning their future.
Okay, well, they're going in again. They both sing. They must have.
I'll try to.
That they're coming out with.
Nah, mate, not me and Chloe. Nah. But you never know.
Bro, you have to.
Well, I might be up for the idea, but I don't think she will.
But listen, bro. That is what we call in America a layup. Okay, I give you a great example. So just follow me with what I'm saying.
Yeah.
Come on, hop on it. That's like Jay-Z and Beyonce being on a big show together, and there's no record behind it.
Oh, I love that. Jay-Z and Beyonce and Steve and Chloe.
No, that... Bro!
There's a big difference.
You have to make that phone call to your man. You have to make it.
What, to...
David Guetta, you have to make that phone.
To David Guetta?
Will we get out
you
our...
You know him, don't you?
Yeah. I get his email, I get his email.
I love that.
Yeah. I think Jay-Z and Beyonce need to wash out. Stevie and Chloe. Do you know what I found most strange about that entire clip? It's been pissing down today and they're all having a casual time in the pool. No idea. Listen, the UK versus USA theme has definitely been causing all kinds of drama already, so I want to know what our panel are making of the two teams so far. Now, even though the house is under the British rule, as we've said, USA seem to be taking over. Now, Rich, I've got to come to you. Mm-hmm. We need to talk about Tash, because good on her, she's one of the first to stick up for herself in there, wasn't she?
Absolutely.
How did you find watching that?
Honestly, it was like watching her in labour again. It was that. I was like, oh, no, not. Like, she's been in there 5 minutes. What are
Funny
you doing?
Funny thing is, we've got that video coming up on 5 Star.
but no, you know, Tash is straight down the line. She says it how it is. She says what she thinks. She's not a stirrer, but if you push her, look out. Feisty, scouser, redhead, do not mess.
Ticks all them boxes. We actually saw Gail again tonight. She was in tears again, complaining about the arguing and saying that the Americans just shout at each other. Michelle, are Team UK being a bit too sensitive about things, or is it the fact that USA are just so there?
I think USA are just so out there, and they're just really extravagant in the way that they explain things. Everything's very big, and everything's got a big gesture. It's like they're literally in theatre. It's like they're playing musical theatre every night. And you know, British people just aren't like that usually. And so, you know, celebrity British people aren't like that usually.
No.
We do not talk like this.
No.
But Americans
do.
Because
speak for yourself.
That was deliberate, obviously. But Americans are playing to a bigger space because America is bigger.
That's why. You have just summed it all up. It's because America is bigger.
Yeah, there you go.
Michelle, we're getting loads of things. Dan, let me come to you. What As a journo and as someone who writes the headlines, what are the Americans doing? Because the headlines have been so American dominated over the weekend. What are the Americans doing right that the Brits aren't at the moment?
Well, look, I think it's always that thing, and that's why it's so great that there's Americans in there, where the Brits know this show. So I would say Sherry, Gail and Natasha, we are just waiting for them to come out of their show. They know right now this is the time to play it cool. Yeah. And just get through, size everyone up. I think Tash, after night one, probably felt a little bit burned by that as well and realised this isn't a situation I want to be getting into. So, look, we are going to see them come out of their shell. You know, Gail and Sherry too, they know how to cause.
Once Sherry's out of Sherry, I mean...
Exactly, and they're great personalities. We're just not seeing it yet, but this is part of the plan, I'm sure.
Do we agree with Dan?
Yes!
Has anyone got something to say?
I think it's a shame that we're not
seeing.
Oh, thank you. It's a shame that we've not seen Sherry so much, but once she gets going, she's just amazing and she's always got funny things to say. And I love that Gail just comes along and just sort of says little things and then go away.
Butter! I love that. That is my favourite thing so far. What do you want on your toast? Butter! Let's talk about Bobby. He's the Prime Minister, but he don't seem to be having much luck taking the control in there. Rich, why do you think he's finding it so hard to keep the House sort of under his rule?
Well, I mean, anyone. It's not an easy task, is it?
David Cameron in there, he won't be able to
do it. Do you know what I mean? No one's going to do that. Send in Mr. T, send in Arnold Schwarzenegger, it ain't going to work, mate.
Not going to happen.
No.
Especially Jenna. She, in particular, don't seem to have any respect for his position, saying, you're the Chancellor or whatever you are. Dan, why are Team USA just totally just pushing him away and going, this ain't happening?
Well, the thing is, they are all reality TV veterans, so they know exactly what they need to do. And also, they don't have the pressure of thinking, how is my career going to be affected after the show as well? Which is why I think we're seeing them be that dramatic.
Let's play a bit of game. Who would we want to see as Prime Minister?
Natasha. I think Natasha would be great in there to do that. She's got that straight out there, go for it. Do what I say and get on with it.
Anyone else?
I want Gail to be Prime Minister.
Why?
Because that's when she'll come out of her shell, she'll ask everyone what they want on their toast, so yeah.
And then get Janice to make her bed. That'd be quite enjoyable to see that. Winston, the Americans might be taking over, but it's not a united front. In particular, Janice and Jenna have clashed in Battle of the Brides, that's what we're calling it. Rich, out of Janice and Jenna, who do you think will win out of that argument?
I don't think Jenna is going to be a walk in the park for Janice. Mm. And I think Janice knows it as well. Mm. So I just think we're all going to have to watch that one play out because it's way too early to pick a winner there.
Jenna seems to have the upper hand over Janice for the minute, doesn't she, Michelle? Yeah. But do you think that will last?
I think in the next 24, 48 hours, Janice is going to retract a little bit because of her reprimanding. I think that she's realised that she overstepped it and she doesn't... Now that she's been given a final warning, she won't want to push it because I think that she genuinely loves Big Brother. Mm. She loves the fact that she's on the show and she just wants to make it entertaining.
Yeah.
You know, that's why she's so successful on the shows because she does really well at entertaining us as an audience. She's not there to really hate on people. I think Jenna could be the person to hate on people.
Well, this is what Jenna said it on launch night. We spoke about this, I think it was Saturday night. We said Jenna said that she's caring, angry and loyal or something like that. We hadn't really seen the angry side then, had we? But now we've seen that with Janice. Is this going to set Jenna up for the series? Because if she thinks she can do it with Janice, she's probably the most sort of frightened-y one, isn't she, Janice? Do you think Jenna might bring out her angry side a bit more now?
I can't stand Jenna.
I really
dislike her. I can't believe that some people think she's nice. What Michelle Visage said, No. I completely disagree. So Janice is going to win that one. You just wait.
Yeah.
You just wait.
Because you might know. You might know. Didn't Jenna and Janice used to be friends? I'm sure.
Oh, did they?
Yeah. I mean, correct me if I'm wrong. Anyone in my ear? No. But I think.
Hello.
I think they used to be friends, and I think they had a little fallout
at
some point. So we might be seeing a bit of old.
It's a shame because I think Jenna was doing herself really well.
I
said, because you've got to do a research chat before you come on the show.
Because they're really professional on here.
We do. And about literally 5 hours ago, I was like, I love Jenna. I actually think she's one of my favourites. And now she's my least favourite, which is such a shame how the tables can turn in one episode.
Janice or Jenna?
Jenna.
Janice. Jenna. They split. Listen, that's all I've got time for tonight. Give yourselves a round of applause. I'm so sorry. Massive thank you to my fantastic panel and our audience. Thank you. I've got to say thank you to Michelle Visage as well, because I love her. Join me here tomorrow night at 11 when we've got all the gossip after the live main show. And believe me, you do not want to miss tomorrow night's main show. Emma's going to be joining me along with John Partridge, Jamie Hensley, and I hope the heating's turned on, because Nikki Graham's going to be here. Until then.